Skyteld Station, which is the Separatist outpost. It was pretty much the core ball from the Federation Star Cruiser, with a bunch of new sort of radar dishes and antenna and stuff. The choice was made to have the antenna sort of stick downwards, just make it sort of interesting looking. Everyone expects the antenna to come up out of the roof, but it just sort of made it look more sinister and different. A certain amount of it was sort of down and dirty. It's really only one corridor over and over again. The sort of newer piece that was designed specifically for the episode was the storage room where Grievous confronts Ahsoka at the end.
Where is the fight you promised me, youngling?
It is full of droid parts and pipes and, you know, recessed floor lighting and everything. Really spooky, though. It worked out really well. The hangar was new too, Skytop Station hangar, which we're going to see a lot in other ships over and over again. That fight scene at the end with the vulture droids dropping from the ceiling was also a really nicely staged action set piece. Just a nice sense of that sort of mayhem that you get in the movies, translating nicely to TV.
We'd seen R2 with all these robotic attachments and saw arms and interface probes, and we thought it'd be really great to actually see him in battle with another R2 droid.
Yeah.
So. R2 was the third character that I designed for the show. And when I say designed, it's like very grandiose. All I did was take the existing design, which is pretty much perfect, and simplify it down a little bit. But R2 has always been one of my like personal favorite characters. There's something about the real R2-D2 paint scheme that just works. I think it's because it's so simple. It almost looks like a superhero outfit with the, just the color across the chest. We do try and stay vigilant with R2 as well. Like we really try to make sure that the claw arm comes out of the right compartment and that the periscope is coming out at the right shape in the head. And we're lucky because now that the movies have all come and gone, we can incorporate every single thing that R2 does, so he's even more of a Swiss Army knife than he was in any one of the movies. I'm sure he can do more, I don't know what it is. We'll have to wait and see.
Come on, R2!
R2 is just fun to watch. It's amazing that something that simple could have that much character, because it really is just a cylinder with a dome on top.
Keep moving, Greasepot.
But for some reason, everyone seems to get into R2. The animators really enjoy working with R2, so it was really fun to just get to see him, you know, involved in some swashbuckling daring do, which is pretty fun.
Goldie. He's black and gold because my brother and I are Steelers fans, and here was an astromech. It was the first one we got to do that wasn't R2, and I thought, well, let me come black and gold.
Tries to kill Anakin.
And then he's a traitor.
That stubby little backstabber.
Well, maybe he knows that Anakin turns out to be Darth Vader. Maybe he's just ahead of the game. Maybe you didn't think about that.
No. The premise of the story was one of the first premises I thought about. It's kind of in the serial tradition of the evil twin. I thought, it'd be great to have R2-D2 have an evil twin.
Matt Wood and Dave Acord, they gave him a different little sound than R2. He sounds a little bit off-kilter.
He's sort of aloof sounding, I think. His voice is everything that all of his sounds. He sounds like he's just sort of whistling to himself.
Are you trying to get us killed?
That sort of becomes creepy by the part two when you realize he's actually, you know, trying to kill everybody.
Right.
And then that sort of like, ha ha ha, is really weird and kind of creepy.
Ahsoka tries to sell the audience on really rooting for this guy. Mm-hmm. But then he is kind of a diabolical, you know, little brat droid.
You think all three is going to open up that door anytime soon?
He's working on it. Patience, Captain.
I like when she talks to Anakin. And
did he tell you your stubby little gold droid pal works for him?
He might have mentioned it. I guess we were all fooled.
And he just kind of shoots her that look. And the animators did great with just that look, like, oh, I told you the whole time this kid was trouble, you know? There's something about seeing those two droids fighting each other that is really fantastic.
I mean, originally that battle, I think, went on for 3 pages. I just couldn't stop it. They were fighting on catwalks and leaping off and
lasers, yeah, and gas jets. And
it was great.
You must be General Grievous. He's just another tinny boys. Let's scrap him like the rest.
We had a really interesting situation where Ahsoka crosses swords with General Grievous. George very specifically said that she's a Padawan. She wouldn't be afraid of Grievous. I remember that. She is very adept. She's very quick. Her size is an advantage.
That doesn't mean she could stand.
Doesn't mean that she would beat him, but she's been trained for these situations to fight.
Sorry to interrupt your playtime, Grumpy, but wouldn't you prefer a challenge?
That wouldn't be you.
He almost toys with her to an extent because she is small and he wants to kill her over a longer period of time. But it was very important that he at one point gets her and has her at lightsaber point. You show that she's not going to win this fight. She's only going to be able to escape it.
And she knows pretty quickly that she's going to have to run to stay alive.
She's buying time. That's all she's doing.
Yeah.
Is buying time. And she might very well die. It's just a matter of survival for that girl against an opponent like Grievous, unless Anakin is there and they can fight him together. But of course, Anakin can't meet General Grievous.
General Grievous, you're shorter than I expected.
Jedi scum!
In Revenge of the Sith, we realize that this is the first time they've ever met each other face to face. So here you have a situation where you have two major characters in the Clone War that can never really meet. They have fought each other, fighter to fighter, but never face to face. It is a challenge because I would like to see that fight of Anakin versus Grievous. Given Obi-Wan's performance against Grievous in Revenge of the Sith, I believe Anakin would take out Grievous fairly easily. It's sad in some ways that the best that we can do with Anakin and Grievous is have Grievous exit one door and it close while the other door opens and Anakin comes out, but they're always, you know, perhaps that close, like ships passing in the night, never really encountering each other till Revenge of the Sith.